I want to know if are you ready? Yes, it seems like you are. Thank you very much for this welcome. Thank you very much for all the people across Guyana here that is represented here. Let me just get on with my speech because it is important that this message get across. His Excellency David Granger and First Lady Sandra Granger, Prime Minister Moses Nagamutu, and let me just stop here. Moses, our elder statesman within the AFC, you continue to serve us well, and I want to say thank you, and I look forward for your continued leadership. Cabinet colleagues, brothers and sisters in the APNU AFC coalition, comrades and friends all, it is a blessing to be here with you because tonight each of us standing here is making history. Tonight, I remind us that we are sitting on the threshold of greatness and of unimaginable possibilities, which with the right leadership will ensure that each and everyone live that good life. That leadership is the APNU plus AFC coalition. It is the only leadership and the only party that has a home for everyone. We don't care from which race, religion, or region you come from, whether you're in the diaspora or here at home, you can just come. In this new Guyana that we are constructing, there is a place for everyone in our AFC APNU home. I want to say in 2015, we started this new chapter in our history. That new chapter saw us picking up the broken pieces and starting the long process of repairing and rebuilding a new Guyana. But come March 2nd, brothers and sisters, you will go to the polls to reaffirm your faith in the coalition. And you will be led by who? David Granger. We will renew our faith in government that will create hope and new opportunities for all Guyanese and their families. We will renew faith in government to create jobs, especially for our youth, and invest in opportunities to boost small business. You will renew your faith on March 2nd in a government that honors and respects our women and will continue to work tirelessly to keep them safe and protected. A government that will strengthen the foundation of our economy and expand all sectors for sustainable development. A government that will enhance the governance of this country with accountability and transparency, best practices to ensure the highest probity in public life. And a government that will complete the constitutional reform process which we started. We have done much, but there is a lot more to do, brothers and sisters. Look at our record in our 4 short years, and you know that with some more time, we will give lots more to the people of Guyana. These are the reasons why the coalition of APNU AFC came together and will stay together. Coalition politics is here to stay because it brings an array of cultures and experiences together, creating a strong, united Guyana. And in unity, there is strength. Never before in our history has any government delivered more in such a short space of time. Comrades, and how do we see Guyana in the next 5 years? What is our vision of it? We see APNU plus AFC as that of a green and prosperous Guyana for all. We see a unified Guyana where we are better connected by another bridge over the Demerara River and in time bridges over the Essequibo and Corentyne. After years of talk, we are ready to turn the sod on that bypass road from East Coast to Diamond. And we will continue to move apace with that road from Linden to Letham. We want to build a nation which everyone has an equal opportunity to realize their potential and enjoy the fruits of their labor without fear or discrimination. Our vision of Guyana embraces diverse faiths and religious groups and their harmonious interaction with each other as we build stronger and cohesive communities. We want a nation whose people at home and abroad take pride in our culture, our heritage, and our patrimony. We want a nation where the environment is protected and preserved for the present and future generations. Young people constitute the largest portion of our small population and continue to face challenges in advancing their ideas and dreams. The next coalition government will do far more to encourage, engage, and empower our youth by implementing policies that will address the challenges faced by our young people. And I want to tell this young the young people this. Young people, we will have a resplendent revenue stream to implement these policies, the oil and gas revenue stream. We will create a mechanism to ensure that our young people participate and have a meaningful input in the formulation and implementation of pub policies at the highest level, just like we ensured participation at the local levels by holding 2 local government elections in 4 years. With the use of technology and increased scholarships, we will train the next generation of petroleum engineers, welders, and other skills our oil and gas industry require. We want to wean the next generation away from cane cutting, a place that the PPP wants to put them back. Now, the results of having worked together should also be told, and there are solid achievements, brothers and sisters. In the last 4 years, we started a program to make fundamental changes to the Guyanese economy. We can proudly claim that our record of achievements in 4 years has outperformed PPP's 23 years of blunders. We have increased the minimum wage by 77% over the last 4 years, moving from $39,500 to $70,000. And they say we ain't do anything for them people yet. By doing this, we have released thousands more from paying income tax, more money in your pockets. And I want you to understand that we must not stop the progress. We have invested $3.2 billion for new and improved hospitals and health facilities. Don't stop the progress! For education, in 2019 alone, we have invested $5.4 billion for new and improved schools and colleges. Don't stop that progress! We have looked after the situation of our pensioners. Today, they get $20,500. Don't stop the progress! We have reduced corporate tax from 40% to 25%. Don't stop the progress! We have instituted VAT exemption for small business earning less than $15 million annually, and we have established a revolving fund for small businesses. Don't stop the progress. Over 375 primary and secondary schools and other educational establishments have free Wi-Fi internet. Our teachers are with free laptops and computers, giving thousands of students also free laptops and computers. Don't stop the progress. Since 2016, the coalition government has spent $43 billion on expanding roads and bridges every region. For 2019 alone, we spent $33 billion for the continued modernization of our infrastructure. Don't stop that progress. We have turned the screws on criminals by applying intelligence gathering and surveillance techniques. In addition to increasing community policing groups all over the country. Don't stop the progress. Comrades, your choice in this election is clear. It is between this coalition government led by President Granger, who is properly qualified and certified. And who led the tremendous progress thus far, or of an arrogant, feral PPP government led by Irfan Ali, whose qualifications are questionable, and who seem not to know where his certificates will come from. And by the way, who certainly will be a puppet to you know who. Do not be fooled or distracted by the PPP's disinformation and fake news, brothers and sisters. They are hoping that our collective memories are short. But least we forget, this is what we had found: lack of transparency and accountability and outright corruption. Contracts they refuse to release. Flagrant racism and victimization. The fact that they held a view that certain Guyanese were never qualified to hold certain posts. You remember that? And the fees at UG We forget UG was free until the PPP introduced fees. You can't believe what they say. And they're plastering Georgetown, saying that they will reduce VAT. But who brought VAT to Guyana? My brothers and sisters, the APNU-AFC coalition represents the best choice for Guyana. It represents hope, opportunity, and prosperity for all, not just a few. It represents the possibility of every Guyanese having a good life. And it is led by a man who is undoubtedly fit and proper, David Granger. Always calm, but strong. Always honest, measured, and intellectual. Government in Guyana needs brains, not bronze. I want to say this. We have both brains and bronze. And if I may say so, the PPP has neither. But our president is also gracious and embracing of the other view. Those attributes we will need in years to come, and they will be to this country's benefit forever. We can do great things when we work together, brothers and sisters. Our APNU-AFC coalition for the last 4 years is proof of that. And so, I ask for your support, your vote on March 2nd. One good term deserves another! And don't stop the progress!